Well, first of all, through this channel, I would like to compliment all the people of state of UP who actually needs to be complimented and credited for this project, which has once again given a landmark like Taj Mahal, which already exists in UP, that if ever there would be a benchmark for a world-class expressway, and when it was built first time, it was in UP and that was Yamuna Expressway. And our organization has been led by respected Jay Prakash Ji, who has been a visionary, a courageous leader, who took this decision to participate in the tender of government of UP when they came out with this project in way back in 2002, if I remember correctly. And we were given this contract when the bidding took place. And even though the organization is known to complete very difficult hydroelectric projects in very challenging situations, as you rightly said, and I am thankful to you, but everyone was skeptical about the Yamuna Expressway, because never a private developer has taken this type of challenge. Magnitude challenge is that 160 kilometer long, 100 meter right of way, entire land acquisition was to be done. And of course, it took more than 9 years. Governments changed, they reviewed the decisions. At the same time, I can say that Mr. Jayaprakash Gorji's resolve was increasing every time, every day, every month, every year. And like Formula One last year, which was successfully done for India, he always believed that if this organization cannot do such a project, then who will do? And I am thankful to God that under Jayaprakash's leadership, a big team of very committed professionals, my colleagues, my brothers, a lot of more than 10,000 people worked tirelessly, bankers supported the project. And I will be making a mistake if I do not acknowledge that way back in 2007-8, it was NDTV which did a very good story on this and interviewed the officers of Yamuna Expressway Authority and talked to the farmers. And in fact, it was a good story, and I'm very happy to say that that story is being completed and a new story starts of development for the Western UP.
Absolutely. If we look back at the project, give us the kind of challenges that you had to face, the kind of project, obviously it's a very large project, so were there any cost overruns in this, and if not, how did you manage to execute in such a short time frame?
Well, it's very clear that it's always in the mind. You see, idea comes, it was an idea and a concept of government of UP, and that idea got translated into a bidding process. But like mankind dreams, someone dreamt to go to moon, now people are dreaming to go to Mars. That's the way Jayaprakash Ji dreams, and he thought that this project can be done. But yes, let me tell you, it was a very challenging project. When we were successful in the bidding process, it was anticipated the entire project would be completed about 4,000 crores. The land acquisition would cost not more than 800 crores. But because governments changed, and rightly land is an emotional issue, the land rate continued to get revised many times. But Jayaprakash Ji was very forthright that when if the project is completed, we have to take things as they fall in stride. And I can tell you that land acquisition cost us almost 3,000 crores against an original anticipation of about 800 crores. Mm-hmm. The project, the final completion cost of the project is about 12,000 crores. Ultimately, the challenges were manifold, land had to be acquired, government of UP, because it was a PPP project, they acquired the land, we bore the cost. Every expenditure on the project has been done by the JP Group, but facilitation was done by Yamunaspe Authority. Then it is a project which is a high bank, high embankment, about 1.5 meter to 3 meter high over natural ground. It had to be a good quality. As you know, this on this side of UP, you don't have stones. We had to get all the stone from Haryana. And then we wanted to, we had a choice whether we make a black carpet, as we know, Dawar Ki Road Banana, or concrete expressway. We went to concrete, not because we make cement, but we wanted to prove a point that they debate whether the concrete road is better or a bitumen road is better. But as an engineer, we know that concrete road is a solution, because if you want less maintenance, so we thought, let us go for concrete road. We used PPC cement, and I can tell you that once people ride on this, they would be proud that whatever challenges were there, because of courage, as I have been mentioning repeatedly, it was a courageous working from the group, bold leadership of Jayaprakash ji, and I will say very focused thought process of different officers of government of Uttar Pradesh, which ultimately made this landmark take its final shape.
Now that the project has completed, it's thrown open to the public, how do you plan to make it financially viable? Because you would agree with me that to recover the kind of cost that you've incurred, you have to make the project financially viable. What kind of traffic growth are you expecting once the project opens up, which would start to commute? And give us plans that you have to make this project financially viable.
Well, I will not make a generic statement. I will only like to make a very specific point. It is not something which I am inventing the words I am going to use. But way back, Eisenhower, the famous president of the United States, said, America did not make roads. Roads made America. What happened to the America we know, the superpower, but roads had to be made. This project has been conceived not because of the toll collection, but JP Infratech, a company dedicated for this project, has two revenue streams. One, land, real estate development, another is a expressway. So the toll collection for first 6-7 years are very low. Maybe, we know it can't even take care of the interest which we have to service for the loan which we have taken. So the barter was that, while I mentioned earlier also, for every acre of land the company has paid for. So there is a real estate land, and we are building a full-fledged city at Noida called Wishtown Noida. So how real estate has to support this this servicing of loan, and that's how this company is going to be viable. The project is viable because, as you know, JP Infratech is a listed company. JP Infratech has been now recording a turnover of about 2,800 crore annually. It is a profitable company. It is paying tax as applicable. It is paying dividend before the road got commissioned. So now the second revenue stream starts. What as an investor, if I have to answer specifically, what they should be happy about is that the first land parcel, there are 5 land parcels in this project. The first land parcel is Noida, the last one or the fifth one is Agra, and the 3 parcels are in between. So entire concept was that you make the road and land parcel become, the value goes up, and then your real estate comes up. And why the real estate? Real estate is directly proportional to the growth in economy. We require towns. You feel very ashamed that if some child dies in NCR or in Delhi playing in a gully or playing in a lane because the guitar, the gutter was open or the manhole was covered, not there. Cities are already staying over the limit. We have to make new cities. Mm. So the point is that, that these five cities, as an investor, everybody was apprehensive, if I can say so, most of the people, that on what happens if road is not complete, then the real estate opportunity is limited. Mm. Now, with the grace of God, the road having completed, now open for public, now that question is over. Now, as India grows, as economy grows, real estate value, real estate requirement will grow, and there are lot of opportunity for the company to grow and investor to be happy about it.
India's number one news app just got even better. Download NDTV's new app, fully optimized for retina display, full screen view, faster response time, and Sudoku. NDTV's new iPad app. Download now.